Hey guys, I got a good one for you. This is going to be for all those non-electricians out there. Those people who know that the only thing you know about electricity is that you don't put your, you don't wet your finger and you put it in the socket. That's pretty much all I've ever learned. And it's kind of unfortunate because my father was worked for the power and light company for, 30 some years. He knew a lot, he just didn't have the patience to teach it. Anyway, so I'm at the Columbia, South Carolina, Petro, and it is 2 in the morning, and it is bright as day out here. It is very cool. They got a bowling alley in there too. Made a nice restaurant. Had me a Philly steak and cheese, and so usually I get up in the morning. I make some coffee, and I've got this thing my daughter got me. This cool mug. It's got a little thing on it that lets me plug it in and heat up, and it's been giving me some problems. So another buddy of mine that drives a truck says, you gotta get yourself a microwave. Gotta get it. Change your life. I resisted, because I just didn't want to mess with the, I didn't want to deal with it. Now, if it was already in there, I'd use it. I just didn't want to be the one to put it in there. And so, I finally broke down and got one. And I said, all right, I'm gonna get me a microwave. So I went and got me a microwave. How about that? I have a note on it. This is how stupid I am when it comes to electricity. I'm not sure, because there's a 12 volt like cigarette lighter back here that you can plug directly in. Of course, you got to buy a $40 inverter to come from the 12 volt cigarette lighter to a plug. So I plugged that in, light turned on, and I said, oh, it works. So then I tried it, and I actually, besides the light, I actually put something in it to heat it up, and then it blew the fuse. So I was like, for God's sakes. So I'm just going to show you how I did it. By the way, this plastic bag, it's got a cloth around it. It's what holds my TV that I don't have a TV. Maybe someday I'll get a TV. And then I just, first I got to get my coffee out. But it is nice to be able to just heat up a cup of coffee or heat up, something microwavable real quick. So the convenience I get, definitely get it. So I am glad I got it so far, but I just wanted to show you how I went through the hassle of rigging it. Really wasn't that big of a hassle at all. It's just, I'd never done it before. So the hardest thing was just getting the fifth wheel grease off my hands when I was done. I'll tell you why. Stay tuned. All right, guys, I just wanted to show this with you. First, you'll have an inverter in the side of your cab. If you do, make sure it's turned on. Then you get an extension cord. I've got a light duty 13 watt max or 13 amp max. Just make sure that it's gonna be able to carry at least 1,000 watts. Clean out your cubby in the side. Plug in your extension cord directly into it. And then just run that all the way around into the front of the truck before you run it all the way through the back there. And let's just make sure it works. So we're gonna just plug it in. Make sure the light comes on. Light comes on, that's good. Then I'm gonna turn the truck on. I don't know why, but a buddy of mine told me to run the power on the truck. Make sure you don't blow a fuse or whatever, I don't know. So it turns on, it works. So we're good to go. So now I'm gonna run the power cord through, I'll unplug it. I'm gonna run it through one side to the other. So I use my fifth wheel release arm to pull it through. Note to self, make sure you clean it off next time. I had fifth wheel grease all over me. I was like, where is this stuff coming from? I didn't realize all that grease stays on the fifth wheel arm, so I was putting it all over the cord and I was handling the cord. But anyway, I wiped it off. Now I ran it up through the bottom part of my bunk on the left side. Ran it all the way up the side of the wall. It's pretty discreet. Just threw it over the seatbelt cover that's up there on the top, and then just connected it directly right into there. So it's connected right into my inverter now. I don't know if it's called an inverter or a converter. I feel like it's a converter, but whatever. It's power, because as you can see, it's plugged in. So I turn the power on whenever I use it. Again, feel free to comment and let me know if that's even necessary. Because one thing I did notice is I'm able to check this. I've got a little unit that'll tell me how much power it's pulling. So it was interesting to me to watch that when I turn the microwave on, you know, it shows right there, it pulls about 1,000 watts. So I knew my extension cord's gonna work, and I actually got to see electricity work. I'm just not familiar with electricity, so that's why I was wanting to do this real simple film, just to show some other people. I'm sure there's others out there that may not know everything about electricity that they need to know. But at the end of the day, it all worked. So, hope that helps. You guys have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon.